So Al-Mu'tasim then plots with the wife of Imam al-Jawad, the daughter of Ma'mun, his niece, Umm al-Fadl, and she puts the poison to him. When he drinks it, he starts feeling the pain. She starts crying. She feels guilty. He looks at her and he says, "You're going to suffer because of this, and you will never have peace after me." Indeed, she became ill with an illness, wal-iyadu billah, that started chewing her. And she wasted or spent all her wealth to become poor, trying to treat her, cure herself, and couldn't until she died. Imam al-Jawad, salamullahi alayhi, gharib in Baghdad, lying on his deathbed. Next to him is al-Imam al-Hadi alayhi salam, looking at his father. Imam al-Hadi told him, "Oh father, it is difficult for me to see you in this state." And Imam al-Hadi was only 8 years old himself. He was also a young imam at the time. But Imam al-Jawad left this dunya at the young age of 25. Imam al-Hadi alayhi salam took care of the ghusl, the kafan, the burial of his father, and buried him next to his grandfather, Imam al-Kadhim alayhi salam, gharib in Baghdad. ويلي على جواد المات بالسيم بالسيم ولا أخو عنده ولا ابن عم. I say, يا إمام الهادي, at least you were there for your father, الإمام الجواد. You took care of him. There were no women and no girls being taken as prisoners, running around crying, "Aywa Husayna." But what happened to your grandfather, Abi Abdillah al-Husayn, on the day of Ashura, all alone in Karbala? It is said Zainab started taking care of the children and the women. At one point she saw there is a girl missing. Where is Sukaina, the daughter of Abi Abdillah al-Husayn? Then she ran to the battlefield. Right there she sees the bodies, bodies without the head, and Zainab is walking through them. Sa'ad Allah qalbiki, may Allah have mercy on you. May Allah bless you, ya Zainab. How did you have that patience to see all these bodies? Until she arrived at the body of Abi Abdillah, a body without a head, a body covered with spears and arrows. She saw Sukaina hugging the body of her father, crying, "Aywa Abataya, Aywa Husaynaya." Zainab came to her, said, "My little girl, what brought you here?" She said, "My aunt Zainab, when the enemies attacked us, when they raided our tents, when they burned them, I thought, let me seek refuge with my father. He might help me. But I saw my father lying here, a body without a head, a body covered in arrows and spears. Inna lillah. Wa inna ilayhi raji'un wa sayya'lamu alladhina zalamu. أي منقلب ينقلبون والعاقبة للمتقين